Hello. I've played a lot of old school RuneScape over the years, probably too much. And now, as an excuse to play even more RuneScape, I'm finally exploring what our beloved pixel game has turned into, RuneScape 3. Hello, hello, and happy April. As you can tell, I'm still rocking my bunny outfit for Easter, and as it is April 1st, I'm also rocking my bench sitting skill cape. Gotta represent the first 99 in RS3. But to quickly dive into what we'll be doing today, I actually have a plan of what I want to do today, which is questing. Obviously, it is April 1st when I'm recording this, so that means all the monthlies reset and I want to get access to some of them. The main one I'm interested in is the Oyster, so I need to do Beneath Cursed Sands. And the other quest that I really want to do is Smoking Kills, so I can get normal Slayer points. Other than that, I have some other quests that I want to get done for a variety of reasons, which should be on the screen now, unless I get lazy with my editing. But with all that being said, let's jump right into it. All right, and that is 30 fire making, so I'm going to actually go ahead and do like my beehives, and I feel like one or two of my other dailies, maybe bust out my daily challenges, and then get started with Beneath Cursed Tides. Okay, so for my daily challenge, I need to do a floor round game, whatever you want to call it, of dungeoneering. So I'm going to go ahead and do that really quick. Haven't done Dungeoneering or looked into it at all since, I mean, when the skill was new, basically. But I'm currently on a Corrupted Gauntlet grind on my OSRS account, so this can't be that hard compared to that. That's first Dungeoneering dungeon completed. Even though that was just combat only, no skills, no complexity or anything like that. I do remember Dungeoneering being a really fun skill when it first came out, and it does remind me a lot of Corrupted Gauntlet. I think that's probably one of the reasons I like doing Gauntlet and Corrupted Gauntlet so much. So I think later down the road, I will definitely do a Dungeoneering grind. But until then, that's probably all I'm going to do for now. All right, it is finally time now to talk to Wizard Myrtle Beach, about starting Beneath Cursed Tides. I love the name they gave the wizard, though, to start this quest. It just fits really well. Well, hold up. Now I'm a little bit confused, because she's saying that Tutorial Island sank into the ocean, but I know people go to Tutorial Island if they don't select the I played recently when they made their account. So what's going on here? Is there a new Tutorial Island floating in the sky somewhere? Hey, Thurgo, I'm back. I have something even better than red berry pie for you, cutie. All right, so we are back on Tutorial Island, and I have to say, not even that far into the quest. I mean, I just got down here. I'm literally in the starting room of Underwater Tutorial Island, but I love what they're able to do with like the new graphics and the new system to do quests like this and make environments like this. One of my favorite things so far in RS3 by far has been the changes to existing quests and new quests and new areas that look like this and are just really cool to experience. I'm pretty sure, yeah, this is the person who did the fishing training on Tutorial Island in the old game. Okay, so it's just mutated Tutorial Island, I feel like. Oh, okay, yep. So I think we just go through Tutorial Island, but underwater, I'm guessing? I don't know. I'll wait until I'm actually through the quest. I have to give her a burnt shrimp because nobody ever cooks the shrimp on their first attempt. Which, I think she's right. I don't know if on any of the accounts I've made if I've ever cooked the first shrimp I got. Actually, no, I definitely have. Never mind. Instead of a bronze dagger, I got a bronze butter knife, which makes sense since we are underwater. Yo, and they're all floating after I killed them. This quest is just sick. I mean, it's so simple, but I think it's such a cool quest. I finally get to complete my childhood dream of robbing a bank in RuneScape. Quest completed, and now time to go do the Oyster Monthly. I keep forgetting that the XP rewards from any quest are in XP lamps, but got fishing up to 40, cooking up to 42, and then I used the combat one on Slayer to get up to 32, so I only need 3 more levels before I can do smoking kills. As much as this bridge has pissed me off in the past in old school, from failing it 10 times in a row just trying to finish Nature Spirit, I don't know how I feel about the fact that you can't fail it anymore. It just doesn't feel right to me. Okay, and that is 25 agility, which is the requirement for the Grand Tree, right? Yeah, the Grand Tree, not Gnome Tree Village. But with that, I actually think before I go ahead and do that quest, I'm going to do the God Statues, I think they are, which is another monthly that I believe gives prayer and construction XP. All right, first statue completed. Got up to level 31 construction. I believe I can pray at this. And that is 1200 prayer XP. And I don't think I get a... Nope, I don't get a level from that. But I'm going to go around and do the other three. I think there's 5 in total, but I think 1 is in Prith. So obviously I can't do the 1 in Prith. All right, and that's all the statues that I can completed. With that, I got a few prayer levels up to level 38 prayer and 34 construction. So with that, I think now I'm going to go ahead and do the Grand Tree. All right, decided to start with Tree Gnome Village instead because I think that's the easier one. So going to do this and then do the Grand Tree. I think that's the order you're supposed to do them in, if I remember correctly. I guess I could have also looked at the quest series and saw that Tree Gnome Village was first. That's okay. But this is going to be the start of Tree Gnome Village. And I'm pretty sure I remember how to do like most of this without a guide, but I am going to use a guide if I need to because I don't have a bunch of time to wander around aimlessly. And I need to help the gnomes. I love them. They're one of my favorite races in RuneScape. Oh, that's bad. I shouldn't have said that. But I mean, come on. They gave us the gnome child. Just look at them. Look at him. Has this dude always been only level 53? There's no way. He used to be like a level like 100 and something. I swear. I'm not tripping. He used to be like level 100 and something. But after this, quest completed and then on to the Grand Tree. Quest completed. I got 11,000 attack XP. Spirit Tree Teleports, and the Gnome Amulet of Protection. Does this have stats? No, it does not. I don't think it does anything, actually, but that pushes me up to 40 attack, so I can actually use Addy equipment. Sweet. I love the gnomes, but I just have to say, they're stupid as hell. I mean, since Gnome Tree Village isn't a requirement for this quest, the king doesn't know what I just did. So I just walk in there and I'm like, yo, you seem worried. And he's like, let me take you downstairs. You see these roots? These roots basically hold our whole society together. If somebody would fuck with these, we're all dead. And he's like, here, I'm going to tell you exactly what keeps us all alive. And here's an issue. Will you help it? And your dude's like, yeah, sure. But then, especially in OSRS, and I'm assuming in RS3, because we have dumbfuck Goffrey or whatever his name is, who betrays them at every turn. And they're like, nah, he wouldn't do that. You're actually the issue. Even though you've saved us like 3 times, you're the issue. They never believe us either when we tell them their problem. I just think they're idiots. But because they gave us the gnome child, I will still help them. Because I love that little dude. I'm glad there's a safe spot for this, because I think I would have gotten smacked by this. I kind of forgot how high level and how hard this black demon could hit in this quest. That is Grand Tree completed. I got 5 quest points, a XP lamp for 18,000 combat. All right, so those XP lamps got me 6 agility levels, got up to 31, and I used the combat XP lamp on defense, got 8 defense levels. So now I'm at 39, so one more level and I'll be able to use adamant armor. And then I didn't get any magic levels from the lamp. But I think with this quest done, I'm going to go ahead and go do Merlin's Crystal and the Holy Grail. Am I in heaven? Gnome child, is that you?
Yes, my child. It is I.
I'm finally home. It's crazy how easy some of these quests are to do without the quest helper. And the only reason that is because I've been obsessively watching Unguided by Alien Food, which I will plug in the description because I mentioned it. But watching him go through all OSRS quests Unguided, I love it. I attentively watch, and now I feel like I know how to do every quest he's done in RuneScape without a guide of any kind. Okay, time for the big reveal, smashing him. Oh, that wasn't as climactic as I thought it was going to be. Well, he just left. Okay. And that is Merlin's Crystal completed. So really the only thing I get is a 1000 XP lamp from the museum if I go talk to the historian. I got Excalibur and 6 quest points. So now time to go do the Holy Grail. I absolutely love that they didn't update the graphics for the Black Knight Titan. This is one of my favorite NPCs because of how absolutely goofy it looks, and I'm so happy they kept it in. Oh, that makes me so happy. All right, and that's Holy Grail completed. I get 15,000 defense XP, which I really wish I wouldn't have used that XP lamp from the Grand Tree on defense, and 11,000 prayer XP, Fisher Realm, and I can use King Arthur's selfie in my POH. Sweet. So that is 41 prayer and 42 defense. Sweet. Well, I think since I'm in Camelot, I'm going to go ahead and do Elemental Workshop 1 and 2. Oh, and combat level 51. Decided to change my mind and start new foundations because I believe, if I remember reading right on the wiki, I have to buy limestone bricks for 2 days straight to get the amount I need to build the fort. So I am actually going to do that now. So then tomorrow I can go ahead and build the fort. And that is Elemental Workshop 1 done. Really quickly, I completed Druidic Ritual and got 10 Herb Lores. Since that's a requirement for the dig site, Elemental Workshop 2, you started over at the exam center. So I thought I might as well just go ahead and get dig site out of the way as well, since I'll be over there. All right, and that is the dig site quest completed. Got 15,000 mining XP, 2,000 herb lore, 2 bars, and then a bunch of other things that I can do, mostly cleaning specimens for the Varrock Museum. But that is 4 mining levels, which pushes me up to 44 mining, and that is 7 herb lore levels for level 17, and that pushes me to a total level of 901. All right, now that I have above 50 quest points, just thought it'd be time to go back to May and claim my rewards. So with that, I get another magical dice. Let's see what we get. We love gambling. All right, 250K, and then a Bob shirt. How much is this worth? 1.4 mil. I can't sell it, but this is a cool thing to have. Awesome. Well, actually, let me put it on. Oh, I'm dripped out. I just want to know who thought it was funny to put the golden egg right here to where you can't even get it half the time. I've clicked on exit so many times trying to get that egg for the daily Easter egg hunts. It's ridiculous. Somebody thought they were real funny with it. All right, just completed my daily Easter egg hunt, and from the casket, I got 300 fire runes, staff of water, Addy salvage, still don't know what the salvage does, water battle staff, and three more pouches. Sweet. Jesus, I forgot how tedious Elemental Workshop 2 really is, especially without rune light. Like, this is just so tedious. My dude just be doing anything for the sake of doing it. And that is Elemental Workshop 2 completed. So I'm going to wait around here until my magic level restores, because I want to make a mind shield as well. No specific reason on why I want to make it. I just want to have it. And then after I do that, I'm going to go ahead and finish new foundations. Damn, I really suck at this capturing the level ups after I complete the quest. But I got two smithing levels, so that is smithing level 41. And then I got three crafting levels, so now I am level 37 crafting. My dude must have went to a trade school or something to expand his business. I started off only being able to make houses, now I can make god statues. I'm building a whole damn fort, apparently. My dude's really up in his game, expanding the business. I love the hustle. And like with all new content that I explore in RS3, have no clue what this does. I'm going to assume, before I say anything, that it will probably be explained at the end of a quest. I just have to make sure that I actually read the dialogue when the quest ends, telling me what this fort does for me. Why is it worth it for me to do it? She just said that Bill is the lumberyard guy. Is he the sawmill operator from OSRS? Has he really grown up that much? Has he expanded his business this much? Instead of just making me planks like a little slave, he's running a fort? Damn, yeah, right here. He was previously the sawmill operator. Good for Bill. I'm happy to see it. Dang, that's crazy. Times are changing. Times are changing, even for the NPCs. Good to see it, though. Good to see it. I think this is my favorite activity I've done in RS3 so far. You know, depositing the segments, running back, making six more, and repeating. And I've been doing this for probably a couple minutes. I wanted to say 10, but I feel like that's way too dramatic. But yeah, almost done. This better be worth it, because this is mind-numbing. All right, that's the rear gate completed, and that is also 40 construction. I also got two strange construction rocks to add to the statue. But I did time it, and it takes 4 minutes, if you do it perfectly, to build one of these sections. And I believe there is about 12 of them. That is 48 minutes of just sitting here and doing this. I don't want to be a whiny baby, but like, they could have made it a little bit quicker just for the sake of the quest. Like, this is an introduction to 4 and 3. So come on, you could have made it a little bit quicker. This is going to take up 48 minutes of my day. Not going to do anything better with it, but like, still. And finally, after an hour of sitting there and just clicking every couple minutes, we have completed new foundations. And it didn't explain to me what this is used for. So I'll have to look up on the wiki. Even before I look it up on the wiki, though, of what Fort 4 and 3 really does, so much construction XP. I mean, I started building these at level 34 construction, and I got all the way up to 47 just from doing this. So crazy XP, which is really nice. But with this finally done, the last thing on my list is to get to 35 Slayer, complete Gertrude's Cat, and there's one other quest that I'm forgetting right now before we can go ahead and do Smoking Kills. Well, because of my daily quest, or my daily challenges, I am now here mining Piss Rock, because it reminded me that now that I have the smithing level and the mining level, I should upgrade my armor to Addy armor. Plus, I did remember that I have the magic level to do some gem enchantments, so I'm going to go ahead and make a sapphire amulet necklace, and same with the emerald. I'm also going to make an emerald ring. I'm pretty sure that's the ring of dueling, just for some teleports other than the lodestone, because that's strictly what I've been using. And here we are with the Addy armor and weapons, and a games necklace, ring of dueling, also made a amulet of magic and amulet of defense, just for a little bit of an upgrade, since I've not worn any rings or necklaces or anything. So with that out of the way, time to finally bust out the last couple quests. What a wholesome reunion. I love a happy ending. Alright, just came out to the Chaos Altar to use the Inferno Ashes that I had from the Wilderness Flash events, because I got assigned an Ice Warrior task, and I know that they would smack through my defense, so I wanted to get up to at least 43 prayer for Protect from Melee. Got up to 45, so now it's time to go and finish that Slayer task. Alright, regretting taking this Slayer task a little bit because these things are ripping me, but I forgot to recharge my prayer, so it makes sense that they're ripping through me without Protect from Melee. But I did take your advice from the last video in the comments saying that I should mess around with my action and revolution bars a little bit. So I actually made some for each skill and made sure they had all the abilities. I don't know if it would switch automatically. I'm starting to think that it doesn't switch automatically, so I did go through and make sure that I have a bar for each combat style and it has all the abilities I can use. Haven't really looked too much into like the order that it's activating. Right now I'm not using manual combat, so I'm not too worried about it since I'm still pretty early in the game. But the main reason I unpaused is because I got Shade Robes, which aren't that impressive, but always a cool item to get. I've always really liked the Shade Robes and how they look. So yeah, but I'm going to go ahead and continue on Slayer until I have 35 for Smoking Kills. This Slayer task has taken so long because these things hit like a damn tank, but that is 35 Slayer, which is the requirement I needed to do Smoking Kills. So with that being said, I'm going to finish this kill, not finish the task, and finally go start Smoking Kills. With 35 Slayer out of the way and all the other quests that I need completed to start Smoking Kills, I think that's where we're going to leave off on for today. With the next episode, we'll start off with Smoking Kills and then whatever else we get into. But as always, I greatly appreciate the support, the feedback, the tips that you all have been offering. I'm having a really good time with RS3, so I'm hoping to continue that. But again, as a reminder, if you like the content and want to support me, please subscribe and or like the video. It is greatly appreciated. But with that, I hope you all have an amazing day. Thank you.